Hi, it's Trixie Mattel, and today we're using CoverGirl. Hi, it's me, Trixie Mattel, and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, I'm a world-famous drag queen with a deep passion for makeup artistry. But that doesn't mean that I've tried everything. We've done a lot of all one brand style videos on this channel. We've done a video of all NYX cosmetics, a video of all Maybelline cosmetics, a video of all Wet n Wild. We've done a lot of drugstore stuff. But to be honest, I usually started those series by picking brands that I like kind of already knew I liked. Today, we're digging into CoverGirl, and I've never used CoverGirl, and I always hear like CoverGirl doesn't cover boy. But as the universe moves forward, anybody could express themselves as a cover girl. You do not have to be born female to feel like a cover girl. I'm gonna be honest, I'm concerned. I'm concerned because I reached out to some makeup people in the community and I said, well, I'm doing a video, I'm gonna do all cover girl. And they were like, I'm worried for you with the cover girl. I'm worried for you, which made me worried for me. I'm gonna glue down my eyebrows and shave, but before I do that, please subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell because I am here alone in my house talking to myself a lot. Today's video is brought to you by Green Chef. Green Chef is a USDA certified organic food company, and it is truly a product that has changed my life. It has meal plans for any type of situation, whether you're paleo, keto, vegetarian, vegan, just trying to try new things. I'm a lifelong vegetarian, so I find Green Chef extremely wonderful. Their expert chefs curate the food. There's like 35 options per week, and you can switch it up anytime and kind of pick out what you want. But I let them pick it for me, and I'm telling you, even if it's a recipe that I'm like, what is that? I don't even know what this is. I love it. I've cooked probably like 40 Green Chef meals at this point. I've enjoyed every single one of them. Not a single one of them has taken me over 30 minutes. Everything is so delicious. It gets delivered to your door in a bag that keeps the food cold. And I've been on set shooting all day where I can't pick up my mail, and I get home and the food is still refrigerated. It comes with recipe cards and pre-portioned ingredients, then that really is what expedites the process. Recipes are super easy to follow. It's step-by-step instruction with little pictures and chef tips, which makes it really great. And you get to keep the recipe card. There's several recipes that I've made that I've gone grocery shopping and bought the same ingredients and made them again. And I'm telling you, every single meal is like, I can't believe I made it. Using Green Chef for so long now has made me a more confident cook even when I'm not cooking a Green Chef meal. I learned to cook confidently from cooking Green Chef. Green Chef is the most sustainable meal kit, offsetting 100% of their materials and carbon emissions in how they pack their food. It's really wonderful. Go to greenchef.us and use the code Trixie130 to get $130 off plus free shipping. I'm telling you, Green Chef changed my life. I love it so much. All right, women, ladies, women, gentlemen, other, we are here, we are bald, we are gay, we have a difficult situation. Just, I mean, it's not that I don't believe in CoverGirl. I just believe that CoverGirl makes certain people very beautiful. And I don't know if I'm one of those people, so like, I don't know. I got my little Trixie Cosmetics mirror. I actually looked for a CoverGirl hand mirror and they don't have one. What does that smell? Oh, I lit a candle. My vibe has been lighting candles for when I get in drag, okay? It's just, let me live. I'm gonna be honest, you guys. I found the selection at CoverGirl CVS to be just kind of like, I thought they made more makeup than this. I mean, Revlon, L'Oreal, Maybelline, all these gondolas have every type of product. CoverGirl doesn't even have that many products. I was kind of gagged by that. This is the CoverGirl True Blend Base Business Skin Primer. They had a few of these. They had like a hydrating one. They had one that was like a clay base that was gray. I was like, who's using a gray primer? I got this one because it said skin smoothing. So usually that means like mattifying. I always think of like Benefit Professional or something like that as kind of like the standard of that, but let's see. I like hydrating primers, but because I'm dry, texture is normally my main issue. So instead of getting a hydrating primer, I'm usually looking for something that's gonna fill pores. I mean, it did make my skin look smoother. This CoverGirl is giving. Do you guys see how there's less texture here right now? Smooth skin and blurs flaws to create perfect canvas. Weightless feel, extends the life of your makeup. I'm gonna stop there. I always with primer tend to like over prime. If I really wanna see if it's doing anything, I'll keep putting primer on, and then when I put makeup on, it doesn't lay right, and then I blame the foundation. This has a little bit of fragrance in it, which I'm just not thrilled about. It smells clean, it smells fresh, but it doesn't smell real, which makes me think like, oh great, I just rubbed a chemical on my face. Does that make sense? I mean, it's makeup, they're all chemicals, but CoverGirl had several foundations, and admittedly, I've never tried any of them, and I didn't really know what to expect here. I grabbed two colors because I didn't know. This is the CoverGirl Outlast Extreme Wear 3-in-1 Foundation. I wanna say the darker one's gonna be better, so let's just try it. The struggle of drugstore makeup, everything is so intensely sealed, which I guess is good, right? All right, ooh, it's real liquidy. Ooh, it's real liquidy. All right, let's just start putting it on. Oh, shit, I'm already worried about this. You know what? If you've joined us for like drugstore videos before, I think the whole energy and the vibe is don't panic. You know what I mean? If you panic, we're never gonna make it through. Maybe I should have used a dry sponge if we're being honest, because I do think this might be shearing it down a little bit. I kind of like the smell. It is like a chemical smell. I think when I was like 18, maybe one of my first purchases was like a CoverGirl pressed powder, and I remember the smell. Actually, this coverage is kind of great. See, you can't panic. You cannot panic too early in the video. You just gotta keep it cool. Don't let anyone find out that you're freaking out inside. Primer, concealer, and foundation all in one. I will say this, if you're a very casual makeup user, it is nice to have a foundation that like you could just use as concealer sometimes. I just always feel like, wouldn't you rather go with something fuller coverage and then sheer it down? I'll decide, I can sheer it down, but don't make me layer something and then tell me it's gonna look natural. For a foundation that says full, it's giving medium to me. It's giving medium. That's how I feel about it. Everybody can fight me. I'm gonna take some of the Outlast powder foundation and I'm gonna do my brows a little bit. I know I don't really ever talk about covering my brows on this channel because I think it's kind of boring, but usually you'll notice I'll do one last layer of glue right before I powder because it kind of helps to have the brows be a little wet. See, and then the powder kind of sticks to it. When I do these drugstore videos, I need to be more like yes and with the experience because I go into it panicked. I go into it like, oh no. But you know what though? A brand like CoverGirl could not be around this long if they were making like absolute flop products. I got my Lunar Beauty giant brush. I just love this brush. A giant brush just makes me feel so fancy. I'm not that disappointed in this foundation, to be honest. I think it's a really good color match for me, don't you think? Like look at to my neck, that's not bad, right? I know I said this recently in another video, I've been trying to go more gold with my foundation because I warm it up so much with blush and stuff, so I like to start a little yellow. But especially being fair and having some redness in my skin sometimes, I like being a little yellow because it kind of cuts the redness. So it's supposed to be kind of a natural finish. I can feel it drying, but I can still see it picking up light. Do you see that? Not ideal for drag, but hey, this foundation wasn't made for drag. That's the thing. Well, on this channel, I need to sometimes remind myself, you are using makeup in a way that other people do not use it. So if something doesn't work for me, it doesn't mean it doesn't work. You know, all things considered, I think this looks pretty good to start. But I feel like all foundation looks good to start. So I was really disappointed with the eyeshadow situation at CoverGirl. I mean, there was like four or five palettes that look exactly like this. This is the True Naked Smoky palette. And I saw the one with the most black and I was like, let's just get that one. Let's just hope that that's gonna work. But first I have the CoverGirl Get In Line Liquid Liner. Up to 24 hour wear, sweatproof, waterproof. To be honest, these little inkwell style ones are not my favorite. I just don't know. I mean, I know people prefer these little inkwells. I just, for liquid liner, I'm like, I would rather use a pen first, then maybe something like a gel, and then like as a last resort, a liquid like this. It's very black, very black. That's a good stopping point. Now, I'm just concerned about this all-day wear eyeshadow palette. New and improved formula with less fallout. We all read that together. We're gonna hold them to that. A palette of intensely pigmented, blendable shades in versatile matte and shimmer finishes. I do think this is kind of a felt. I'm not even gonna address what this is. This is the palette we're working with today. I think it's functional. It says matte, but like, the way that every color in this palette picks up shimmer, I'm like, how mad are you? But let's just go for it. I'm just gonna start with these kind of darker colors and I'm just gonna hope. I mean, it's a very even application, I'll say that. It's definitely, I mean, this is definitely going better than I thought it would be. I'm always afraid to say anything like that because the second I say that, the universe is like, is that what you want? Well, let me tell you, you're never gonna get it. You like how I blame the universe for my poor makeup application? I'm gonna pick up a little bit of this gray here and try to windshield wiper some of this out. The issue is that the back of this palette said matte and I'm looking at this and I'm like, that's not true, Ellen. You were invited. This is not a matte shadow. I mean, can you guys see my eyebrow texture being picked up? If this was a truly matte shadow, it would be hiding the texture. This shadow is kind of revealing it, which I find a little annoying. If this was advertised as like a demi matte or a satin shadow, I wouldn't be so annoyed, but this isn't what it says it is. So it's not the worst. It's not the worst. It's not the worst. It's really not the worst. Let's do a little bit under the eye. Now, this is like my little tricksy tip when you're using cheaper shadows. I sometimes like to use liquid foundation as like primer, because if you can apply shadow while it's wet, it sort of sticks to the liquid. And you can use eye primer, but I do think liquid foundation grabs more sometimes. Let's get this black. Let's get it really tight. I'm gonna do like just a round kind of smoky situation today, because this palette was made for smoky eyes. So let's try to do what the product is made to do. Okay. They could have at least half lied and said that this is like a natural matte finish shadow or something. You know what I mean? So then if you're a girl like me, a very special kind of girl with very special unique needs with makeup, you're like, well, please do what you said you do, because I'm not 17 years old and cis female and I don't look gorgeous in every lighting. Please help me. Besides the finish of this shadow being inaccurately described in the packaging, the blendability is actually really nice. And I don't have a lot of fallout. The package is not lying to us. Except about the finish. The packaging definitely lying about the finish, but this is kind of the shape I'm gonna do, and I'm gonna do that on the other side and be right back. All right, I'm back. I finished off the other side and I threw on some brows quick with just the Brow Ultra Slim from CoverGirl, because I bought a CoverGirl brow product and I think we'll add to it, but I just was like, this is not gonna work for me. I have no patience for this packaging, you guys. I'm not a patient person. It's just not my greatest gift. Ooh, there's a brush. Oh, this actually is a really cute little brush. Look at the precision there. Easy breezy brow. At least I know no one's opened this, right? I'm not a criminal. Although you would think I mean, at my CVS, maybe it's because I'm 6 feet tall and because I'm bald and because I wear a lot of black, but I just, whenever I go in there and I shop for makeup, I linger in the makeup aisle. I'm there an hour sometimes looking at makeup, shopping. I mean, I read packaging. I want to know what the tea is, but they always are looking at me like I'm a criminal. And I'm like, I'm not gonna, if I was stealing, you would know it. You know what I mean? I wouldn't be lingering for an hour. I'd walk in and take and leave. Hello? These look very, very sheer, but I'm okay with that. I mean, I've been trying to do lighter brows in general. This actually looks really good. This brow color, right? I don't know anybody else who's blonde or does light brows. I know that at drugstores, brow products tend to be very ash, very almost gray. And then I get home and the products are like too gray for me to use in my brows. Cause in drag, I kind of like a warmer brow. Look how nice that looks. Am I making it up or doesn't that look kind of good? I'm gonna use a little bit of the darker side on the end. I know one of the last videos I said I would stop licking the brushes. Well, Rome wasn't built in a day. Okay. That looks really good, doesn't it? See, I'm being hateful, I'm being unfair, and then I open the product and it works really good. That being said, this is just a joke to me. This is what you should do with these. You pull them out of the packaging and you throw it away. I mean, there's just no reason to even pack those. No one's using those. Isn't it Clinique or something where they apply all the makeup with like Q-tips and cotton balls? Do you guys know what I'm talking about? What makeup counter do they use all Q-tips and cotton balls? Would you guys gag if I did an all Clinique video? I thought about it. I thought about getting a white lab coat and like a white background and doing all Clinique. I've never used Clinique. Let me know if you would like to see that. All right, that looks really good. And if we're being honest, the skin looks pretty good and the shadow looks pretty good. So CoverGirl is kind of gagging me right now. I don't have any fallout from this big black eye I just did. I'm kind of living and I didn't expect to be living and here I am alive. So I don't know. Now in the small amount of research I did for the brand, I asked some other makeup people about CoverGirl and they were like, I don't know. But they were like, honestly, that concealer's good. And so this is the concealer in question. This is CoverGirl True Blend Undercover Concealer. This is Fair Porcelain. This is the lightest. And I have learned that CVS doesn't always have the full range, but I do think for CoverGirl, they had pretty much everything. Wow, that blended out nice, didn't it? Am I being ridiculous or does that look kind of good? How many times do I have to tell myself to have an open mind and then when something works, I act like I didn't expect it to work? And maybe I need to actually practice what I preach. It's nice coverage. It's definitely blendable in a way that like for my type of makeup, I actually don't want a concealer to blend this much. I want it to maybe stay a little stark because I'm shaping my face a little bit. I'm like, that's how much I kind of, like, I really need a little pop right there. A little pop. I was talking to Manny at CVS and he was like, I don't know about CoverGirl. And if I slay this beat, I'm gonna call him and be like, and what, bitch? Team CoverGirl. Am I a CoverGirl? These people who said CoverGirl doesn't cover boy didn't know what they were doing. This looks great. I'm gonna use the same color and I'm gonna take a very small concealer brush. This is Hank and Henry. You guys know I love those brushes. And I'm gonna use this concealer to shape around my brows. And I think this is where I can kind of tell if I like concealer when I'm doing this part. Do you think when RuPaul put out CoverGirl, do you think that CoverGirl liked it? Or were they like, ugh? If you haven't listened to RuPaul CoverGirl in a while, I'm telling you, it slaps, it holds up, and every time it's a new boost of serotonin. I'm kind of gagging! Ooh, it definitely dries down fast. This might be water-based. I can feel it kind of drying quickly. Gag! That looks pretty good, I think. I don't know, maybe I'm too easy to please. I think, let's just address the situation. I used very affordable makeup for a very long time. So I think that I learned how to make not nice makeup perform well. And not that CoverGirl's not nice makeup, it's just not made to do what I'm doing. And I learned to make normal makeup do abnormal makeup things. It's a very large doe foot. This is honestly feels very similar to the e.l.f. 16 hour camo concealer, which I love. I love that concealer. I'm kind of floored right now. Like, this looks really good in person. I don't know what to say other than this is good. Very full coverage. It feels moisturizing. I mean, you know how sometimes concealer, as it dries, if it's a full coverage concealer, it can feel like tape stretched across your face. This color is caramel, and I'm gonna start to do some of my shaping on my face using this color. As you guys know, I'm not like other girls. I have to use contour to shave down half my head so I can look partially human. And lately I've been buying the lightest shade of a concealer and then the very darkest and then something in the middle. And then I just kind of like make it up as I go and kind of mix them. I get so stressed out about trying to find the right color of things, but then I'm like, if I just buy a few, I don't have to worry about the right color. You know what I mean? That looks really good. I'm gonna take the slightly deeper shade, which is deep gold. And this is the deepest that my CVS had, which is, I don't know. It's not deep, but it's definitely not like True Match or something where there's a million colors. Spoiler alert, I bought a bunch of L'Oreal to do a video too, and I was kind of stunned by the shade range. You got a little tiny forehead. Work. Slay! Hold on, the Red Bull's hitting. I'm gonna do something unprecedented, which is I'm not gonna cut my cheek with the darkest color. I'm gonna cut it with this middle color. I'm gonna go with this darker color. That looks really even to me, right? I mean, if this makeup turns out, I'm gonna be really shocked. Work. You guys, these concealers are extremely easy to work with. Like, that looks so even. I'm thinking of Nick the editor and I'm like, you're watching this and I know you like to chime in sometimes and say horrible things, but this actually looks pretty good, right? Right, Nick? He's not here, but I'm just like speaking to his existence. That looks good. Okay, I'm shocked, I'm stunned, and I don't know what to do with the information, all right? You guys, I'm gonna do the other side and come back. I can't handle this type of emotional turmoil on the channel today. All right, I mean, the concealer is on, the shaping is done, the foundation's on. You guys, honestly, it takes a lot to shaketh me. I'm shaken. This is CoverGirl Clean Professional Loose Powder in Transparent Fair. I've actually had this before. The last time I bought this, I was maybe 18. I used to walk to the CVS and use my little money from waiting tables or delivery driving or whatever, and I would buy drugstore makeup and just take it home and play with it secretly in my bedroom. The smell. Oh my God, does this take me back, you guys. Wow. God, this makes me think of my first apartment and like having a fishing tackle box full of makeup. I don't know what the finish is supposed to be. It looks like it's gonna be matte, but I really don't know. So let's just, what a weird puff, right? Like a little hairball. I kind of like it. And sometimes with brands, I find that like, if you use their product, like if you use their setting powder with their foundation, it does work a little better. So I'm hoping for that to happen today. God, it makes me really feel like I'm like 19 years old. All right, I think I'm powdered the house down. Going with my lovely Lunar Beauty brush. I'll say that I think this powder has a natural finish. It's definitely not a matte powder. This is like a natural matte finish. Not my favorite for drag, but for a human being. CoverGirl makes a pressed powder that's a full coverage powder that allegedly wears for 16 hours. The lightest shade that I could find was Classic Ivory. And I'm gonna kind of set the high planes of my face. If you were a real person who did this, you would look kind of insane, but for drag, it really helps. So I'm gonna go in with Natural Tan, which is kind of my medium shade. And I'm gonna try to kind of start recontouring the edges of this sucker. And this is like a general tip. I know that I contour a lot, but I also really believe in contouring with two different colors. So then I'm gonna go in with that deeper one, the Sable, and do really like the pockets of the face. See, just a little more depth in the pocket, it makes a big difference. Let's do the hairline a little more. The deeper one just along the underside of the jaw. I'm just gonna get a little closer. Don't you think this looks kind of good today? Like, this is CoverGirl. I'm wearing all CoverGirl. But I got a mascara, a little blast from the past, a lash blast from the past. I bought it in black brown. Whatever, I guess we're using black brown mascara. I was in college in the years of like 2007, 2008, 2009, which is when everyone was using CoverGirl Lash Blast. This tube is so like, I don't know, I just think of this tube. I think of girls I went to college with. And I love the brush on this mascara. I know it's a little basic, I love the brush. This brush is really good at separating, which is fabulous. So we are at the point where I have to do my black and white liner on my eyes. CoverGirl did not make a white gel liner or a black gel liner. I'll be back. All right, I got some liner on, and let's cut the crease a little bit with this little fantasy CoverGirl Get In Line Active Liner. That is nice. I love cutting a crease, you guys. Look how nice that looks. I'm so gagged, you guys, right now that this is working out so well. But before we celebrate too soon, I got some blushes, and God, I gotta tell you guys, this makes me think of my beautiful grandma who I loved so much. She used to use these CoverGirl's Cheekers blushes, and I remember being a kid and like going and sneaking into her bathroom and putting it on my face and like playing with it. When a product like this has been around this long and it's basically not been changed in any way, it has to be because there has to be something that's good about it. Hello? Do you see blush? I don't. Hello? I'm really having to like pack this sucker on. Do you see it? I don't see it, but I've been trying to wear less blush anyway, believe it or not. I think it's just a little light for me. I think that might be the issue. I can see it. Maybe that's why people like this blush, because it's extremely sheer. So if you don't know what you're doing, it's very hard to put on too much. If you've used Trixie Cosmetics blushes, you know that I prefer slightly more impact from blushes. So I got two different lip colors here from CoverGirl. Outlast Ultimate Liquid Lip Color, and I got an Exhibitionist Lip Gloss, but I have no pencils because there was no CoverGirl pencil. So I'm gonna have to do my own pencil thing. What kind of color is this? Oh, it's actually a lot darker than I thought it was gonna be. We've got a lovely Soar lip pencil, which you guys know is just kind of my go-to for drag work. This is NYX lip liner in Natural. It's a great liner if you are very fair and you need something close to just a lip color. And I'm just gonna like chisel the inside of this to do like an ombre. So let's put on the lip. We have the Ultimate 24-Hour Wear Outlast. Not in love with the applicator. You guys, it's one of these like baby little doe feet, like the size of a Q-tip. Not in love with that. I mean, this just doesn't, the applicator doesn't apply much at once. So I don't even know if I'm getting like coverage. If we're being honest, I like the color of this sort of very muted, it's almost gray. I like the color, but I had to dip into here like 8 times. But I like it, I like the, it definitely dries down. It smells like nothing, it smells like chemicals. I got a lovely Exhibitionist gloss here, and I am gonna put this on, but I'm gonna put on the wig, etc., and I'm gonna be right back. I feel beautiful. I haven't worn this hair in forever. This is the hair from the cover of my first record, Two Birds. It still looks great. Wigs by Vanity. Let's just go through it. I don't even want to put this gloss on because I just really like the lip the way it is. So I'm not going to end up using this CoverGirl Exhibitionist gloss, but you know what? I will use it someday. But let's just go here. Let's get into it. First up, I have to say, I think the eyes look great. I think the lips look great, whatever. This complexion, you guys, is really gaggy. Really gaggy. Like, my pores are gone. It's not as matte as I'm used to, but it really is smooth. So I have to say, the CoverGirl True Blend Base Business, this did what it said it was gonna do. I mean, it smoothed skin and blurred imperfections to make a smooth canvas. This is maybe the best my pores have ever looked in this region, ever. So this is great. This is actually really beautiful. CoverGirl, I'm wearing the makeup that your mom wears. It's gaggy. This foundation, CoverGirl Outlast Extreme Wear 3-in-1 Concealer, Primer, and Foundation. I'm shook. The coverage was about as good as Maybelline Superstay, which is kind of my go-to drugstore foundation. We'll probably wear this again in drag. I look great. This looks, my hands, I did my hands, they look great. I mean, this color match was right on. It says it has 24-hour coverage. I'm not leaving this on for 24 hours. Full disclosure, I do things in foundation that normal people don't do. Normal people put on foundation and they like ride the bus, go to work, go on a date, whatever. I'm in a corset with singing under hot lights. Like I really test foundation, but I really like this. How much is it? Let's see. This is $15. This is gaggy. These concealers, I mean, come on. These CoverGirl True Blend Undercover Concealers. I have nothing but fabulous things to say about these. They sculpted my face perfect. Look how nice that is. Look at the forehead. Look at how like blended that is. And I didn't even work that hard. I love when things work out. I love when good things happen to just okay people. The setting powder, I didn't expect to like as much as I did. I guess because this wasn't a mattifying powder, it had like a natural finish, I was afraid it was going to look textury, but I actually think that it looks natural and that helped hide texture. Of course, I personally wish it would have a little more coverage. That would be great, but I think it looks really, really beautiful. The Easy Breezy Brow was kind of a surprise hit here. I know I did a little bit of my brow beforehand with my Maybelline brow pencil, but look at how nice and soft that looks without looking too gray or brown. I mean, that looks perfect. And then it has two colors, so I was able to really get in here. So this is pretty gaggy. I like this. The 16 Hour Outlast Extreme Wear Full Coverage Powder. I mean, this is pretty amazing. This looks and feels like StudioFix powder, which is kind of my previous favorite. I didn't get a lot of like kicking up on my face. Beautiful. Wow, this looks beautiful. I love it. I've never felt so positive on this channel. This liquid liner, it's fine. I mean, there's a lot of other options at the drugstore that are similar price point and probably a little easier to work with. That being said, this does have a nice, very fine little tip. I just don't turn up for liners like this in general. No offense to this, it's just not my thing. The lip color, I love the color. This Outlast Ultimate in Prosecco Pop, I like the color. However, the chemically smell is not my fave. And I don't love this teeny little wand, but then again, I draw on giant lips. I would never choose like a muted gray purple like this, and I think it's really pretty, so. CoverGirl Lash Blast, I mean, I did accidentally buy black brown, but this brush is amazing. It just really like shapes and individualizes lashes. This is the only like I'm not living product, this CoverGirl Cheekers Blush in Natural Rose. I put on a lot, and I still barely see it. This is really sheer. I'll probably never use it again, but it's fine. I can see why it's very user-friendly. It would be impossible to put on too much blush with this. And the shadow palette, I mean, I used 5 of these shadows, and I mean, this eye look is beautiful. I do wish the mattes were more matte. However, the fact that there was no fallout from this really got me together in a way that I did not expect. So the verdict here, CoverGirl, you gagged me. Not a single item I used today was over $12 or $15. I got $10 extra care bucks from CVS, so I'm living large now. This was great. I wish I could like wear test this. I'm not a normal YouTube channel where I can be like, I'm gonna go about my day and update you on the foundation wear. Mary, I'm not trying to be in drag longer than 4 hours. So when something says like 24 hour wear, I'm like, that has nothing to do with me. That last 20 hours, I don't care what happens. You know what? I'm gonna call Manny and I'm gonna let her know what the tea is. She's gonna gag. She's not gonna care. She might gag. Hello.
She's B to the ground.
Yes, can you believe? Guess which one it is.
CoverGirl.
It's CoverGirl.
You're lying.
I'm not lying.
Boy, I'm actually really, really impressed.
I wish you could see it in person. It's really gaggy. I just can't believe this is all CoverGirl.
And that's also a testament to your artistry skills because, come on.
All right, well, I'm gonna go get out of drag. This was really surprising. I'm gagged.
I live it for you.
All right, I'm glad you could pick up because I was shocked. I have to go reflect. Shout out to CoverGirl. You gagged me. You gagged me, CoverGirl does cover boy. I mean, I feel so gorgeous, you guys. I can't stop looking at myself in the monitor. But thank you for joining today. This was a surprise hit. I feel so beautiful. I really recommend a lot of these products, especially scoop up that concealer. That concealer is lit. Goodbye.